Hello and welcome back to Kaiserreich. We gotta turn up this music a little bit. It's a bit low. Alright, let's see here. So, we've got the encirclement done. And it is time to try for another one. As you do. As was mentioned in a past video's comments, I believe the last video's comments, we have established the precedent for how this war will be won. It'll be slow, it'll be arduous, but it'll be won through encirclements and the creation of pockets. There, I do see some actual... Oh my, why are you doing this? Don't do this, just hold. I do see some actual legitimate situations on this side here where we could actually try for encirclements or push us like breakthroughs on the Dutch line, but for now we gotta focus on Iberia. This is the Iberia first strategy. We gotta get that done, like Europe first in the real world, while the Sicilians are pushing steadily into northern Italy, which I'm extremely happy about. We can do this. And also, god fucking damn it, I hate that. I might just end up... No, I was thinking, like, I might just end up turning off the copyrighted song list on the Norway videos and just play the default soundtrack, but then I can't, you know, every now and then get a hold of the Mountain King. Also, I don't usually talk about politics and stuff. So, and don't worry, don't start sweating yet. I'm not really gonna talk about politics, but I saw something very stupid. Because if you're American, I forgive you, but your president cannot leave us alone. He tweeted, I think, a video which was like doctored version of like a Time magazine video thing about how, you know, Trump's effects on the world aren't gonna disappear when he leaves, which obviously he was the president of the United States, but in it he used Edvard Grieg's Fall of the Mountain King, while a bunch of signs saying Trump, you know, 2048, Trump 3026, and Trump, you know, year 5000 were rolling by. And I'm like, dude, just please leave us alone. We don't want to be a part of this shit, dude. Also, like, whenever he, I think he mentioned something, like, I'm an avid reader of the news, if you couldn't tell. He mentioned something about, oh yeah, when he made that, like, infamous, you know, shithole countries, comment, which, yeah, he also mentioned, like, unlike, you know, for example, Norway, and I'm like, dude, just, don't even mention us, please. You know, Norwegians are always like, you know, oh shit, someone mentioned us, and like, hell yeah, dude. But, when it's in regards to American politics, we'd rather not. We've got enough problems of our own here with, you know, the fucking spice manufacturing plant not working and them having fired the dude who built it, so they don't know how to fix it. Oh, dude, Norwegian problems are stupid. Like the problems we have. It's like, because I don't even feel like I'm being political. I think it's funny. It's the thing. Alright, we're gonna push through here. We actually will be able to do this encirclement, I believe. Those tanks still haven't actually reinforced, which, oh yeah, we've only got 7. Can we ramp up production at all, or is it limited. We can probably lower the production of artillery guns. We don't need as many of those anymore, which starts up the production of the jets. But our problem with the tanks is chromium right now. So who can we buy chromium from? Oh my fucking god. Okay, let's see. Who can we buy chromium from? Union of South Africa, of course. Good trading partner. And we could... See, what do we need aluminium for? It's probably planes. It's for the jet and for the strat bomber. I'm gonna lower that because strat bombers do suck up a bunch of aluminium. I'm gonna just continue the push immediately, actually. Because I see a weak spot here. Yeah, speaking of, like, stupid Norwegian problems, because I... Hopefully the people who are watching who are Norwegian empathize with this, but some people might get mad at me for saying this. Hopefully not. We have a, kind of a stupid situation right now in Norway where, we cannot keep a hold of one Minister of Justice, which is like the, you know, the person who basically is in charge of the departments that have something to do with, you know, law and order and all that garbage. We've sort of gone through a bunch of those, this government, and every one of them has to, like, either resign or, like, or, well, they have to resign on the kind of threat of consequences if they don't, because they've all done some dumb shit. It's a very silly situation. It's all comparatively benign shit compared to like what goes on in the rest of the world. Which, oh my fucking god. Speaking of which, what goes on in the rest of the world? This is fucked up. Okay, we gotta win fast. But yeah, the, all our problems are relatively benign, most of them at least. But the fact that they are so benign is what makes it fucking stupid, because, you know, you can always just not be an idiot. Then again, there are a lot of idiots in the world, and if it was that easy, we wouldn't have those. I shouldn't say idiots, that's kind of mean. A lot of people who make poor decisions. As we all are prone to do now and then. Alright, once we get these guys reinforcing, we should be able to easily push into this single mountain division here. And encircle these few divisions. There's not very many of them, but at least it cuts off a bunch of them that would be holding the line. You can see the lines are very thin right now here. It cuts off a bunch of those that would be holding the line, giving us a clear numerical superiority here, which means that we can actually start just pushing across the entire line, I think. I think that would be possible if we just do this. And it also closes down the line, which means that all these guys who are covering the bulge, which, you know, you have to spend more people covering the bulge than the people who are in the bulge, those will then fall down onto the line as well. Yeah, this is what you wanted. The more videos I make, the more, without stuff to talk about, the closer and closer I inch towards talking about stupid political bullshit. I'm kidding, it's fine. I think I'm quite good at, like, avoiding vitriolic subjects. I don't want to talk about stuff that's, like, actually upsetting to people. Rather just to have, foster a positive atmosphere and stuff, because there's a lot of negativity on YouTube. And I mean, you guys can probably tell. Your recommended videos are probably swarming with negativity. Negativity gets clicks and gets, you know, people who are engaged, because angry people will comment more and will like more and will continue watching because they're very angry. Probably one of the easiest strategies for getting views and stuff. Not gonna go with the heavy tanks. I'll just do the amphibious tanks. Again, I don't know really how to use them. If anyone out there actually does, please let me know, because I'd like to try using them. Dude, fucking mountains. One mountain in division is inflicting heavy losses against a full, like, 7-8 divisions of in. This is the power of mountains, dude. Probably should have sent the mountain infantry over there, but hindsight is 20/20. I'll keep these guys over here, though, because we're going to need them once we actually start pushing. The Marines, they can actually go wherever, which means probably they should go somewhere specifically. And no, that's a port. We can't encircle there. I saw all those divisions and I was like, yo, just land here and just run up north. We should probably send these guys off to Mallorca. That's Mallorca, right? One of those is Mallorca. And have them perform a naval invasion of Barcelona, of course. The idea being we can potentially push them further towards a well, that's a route. We can push them further towards capitulation that way. Why are you doing that, Portugal? Made a very ill-advised attack plan there. This will help out this one. There's really no reason not to do so. Other than the fact that, of course, we will be extending our lines a bit. I'm very proud of the Sicilians, like... Oh my god, this too. Yeah, I'm actually extremely proud of what's happening here right now. I think it's purely because of the extremely they have dedicated their troops to India right now, because they need a lot of troops to hold all these fronts, and all these troops are not in Europe right now. I'm guessing India has pulled all their troops out of there, which is not a good idea, because now we're going to lose all that Indian manpower, and they still had a lot to give, and all those Indian divisions. That's extremely bad, but if we can be quick about this, we can potentially turn this sad situation into a good situation. Also, speaking of a sad situation, which is also a good situation, we have a nuke. And I'm thinking we do the thing that I said I wanted to do last time, which I can't do right now, obviously. Well, fuck. I'm thinking we'll use it then. What do we have here? Nothing. I'm thinking we'll use it then somewhere like... Did we nuke Leon already? I've got a faint recollection of having dropped a nuclear bomb on Leon. Perhaps we'll drop it then. We can't drop it in Italy either. It's way too many planes. Might actually be because of all the aluminium in France and stuff that they're getting, that they can actually keep this plane production up. I need these guys to help out, but I mean, they probably don't even have enough manpower to really fight. Yep. The Dominion of India has capitulated. Fucking hell, that's bad. Gotta figure out how to like prioritize the various production here. Because the higher up they are, the higher priority they get on resources and stuff. Alright, we'll just swap the troops out. Or we'll just immediately attack. Because they're moving troops out of that position. They're also moving troops into that position. Whoa, what the fuck? Oh, they're abandoning the position. Which means, of course, we want to pin them so they stay in there so we can actually kill them. But we're not going to be able to push them off this tile, so we're not actually going to be able to perform that encirclement at all. We're going to take the territory, but so tactically it's a victory, but strategically not the victory I wanted. They've completely abandoned large swaths of this line, so we can now, I think, say with almost complete assuredness that that Iberia will fall. It's only a matter of time, unless all those troops somehow magically make their way towards Europe. If we can get a double capitulation here with the Iberians and the Commune of France capitulating roughly around the same time, we could do something huge. Also, I might... oh, these are miners. Or they're not even... They're not miners, but they're not huge either, so I don't know if I'm going to waste a nuke on them. They're, like, not that we necessarily have the best situations to use them in to begin with all the time either. Oh, they're actually moving into the pocket. Well then, once they're done moving through this spot, I'll try to attack. Once these guys actually reach this tile, I'll have them support from a side as well, so that we get the multi, multiple front attack bonus. Not that we'll necessarily need it, but it's going to speed it up so they don't get their reinforcements here into the region. Continue the attack, yes. Alright, we took it. So now we have another encirclement here. Which actually, I'll try to keep some of the infantry behind, just so that we can use those to attack these positions here as well. And of course, we never get any traits. That's to be expected at this point. Oh, fucking hell. Okay, there we go. The tank was, what the fuck? Oh, Heartsmind 4, why though? Why are you like this? Oh, I hate that. So, the tank was... lost the moment these guys arrived, so even though they had right before these guys arrived, so even though they had had all the organization they needed and more, they still got beaten back because the tank got beaten back, so they all decided to retreat with the tank, which makes no fucking sense, but sometimes the game mechanics don't. Like, sometimes the game mechanics do unexpected things, and that happens in all games. Kind of, sad. But nothing to whinge about. Oh my god. We gotta get all this, yeah, we gotta get our infantry in there. Real quick. Okay, we're holding. Oh, that's Liberia. Let's see, where is France? Or can we? Hold on. No, we can't really. I was gonna say we should maybe divide it between Middle Africa and France, but probably best if we just give it all to France. Though in fact, I do need to reset. I need to pass a bunch of turns in order to actually take all the territory. And let's see, let's find France again. Take all states, and turn, and done. Now the Kingdom of France can send their troops back up north, so that we don't need them in the south, in France. Or sorry, at this point it might as well be, but in Africa. This is a horrible, horrible mess. We are still sinking French destroyers here and there. And these guys haven't declared war on Canada. Yeah, they haven't decided between friendship with Mexico or war plan green yet. Lucky for us. Why is he retreating into that tile? That doesn't make any sense, but okay. Alright, there we go. Encirclement complete. Now for the full and total push, which should, I believe, come from the south. That would be the best. However, oh, the Sicilians actually took the territory we were planning on naval invading, in which case we'll probably invade maybe Cartagena instead. That way we can potentially link up with these guys who are currently in an encirclement, or in a pocket of their own making, of course, but can potentially help them out a little bit. Yeah, I think maybe it's time for us to, for once, use front lines again. Oh, of course. I gotta stop. Make sure these guys are assigned there. There we go. Just in case, because they are part of the same army, of course. Oh, the Marines are actually doing really poorly, so I'm gonna exercise them, and I'm actually gonna... let's see, I'm gonna remove them from that plan. And, let's see, we'll create an offensive line, and we'll put it somewhere over here. Try to push down south, and then we'll have the push over here. Potentially, if we take the entire coastline, we can encircle the entirety of the Spanish army in the mainland. It won't, I don't think, create an actual encirclement because of the fact that they still have hold the capital. And I think that supplies do still stream out of the capital, Hearts of Iron 3 style. Oh, of course. When I select two of them to exercise, I select all of them to exercise. Guess we'll have to do this then. Let's see, who's got invader? 10%. Don't think any of these guys have invader. I think it was Gustav Fleischer who had invader, or was close to it. Oh, he might not. Oh, he's not getting any traits maybe because he's at max. Though the others should be getting traits though. Yeah, it's just stupid. Let's see, who's got the highest attack then? William Steffens. William Steffens, you will be the new Marine leader. The Telemark Corps, named now for the Telemark Battalion, Telemark Bataljon, which is a kind of like an elite Norwegian battalion. They've served in numerous places, I believe, like Afghanistan and stuff. Our forces aren't attacking because we don't really have a lot of anything, really. And the enemies are repositioning and getting back into, like, proper defensive positions here, which can become problematic. Let's try it for a moment. See how it goes. Backing across the entire line. Not helpful because the Portuguese troops are not helping. I think we'll have to micromanage the entire line, I think. In some places they're fighting well, they're fighting in a manner which I would say is effective, and some places they're not, because they're... So when you do this, they'll sometimes, like now, try to focus on taking too much territory at once instead of trying to focus on taking bits of territory first. So for example, in places here where they could have all focused on one spot, they started focusing on different tiles instead. So like, they divided their effectiveness instead of trying to reach more goals in a faster timeline. They try to reach more goals in a on a longer timeline, which is not actually how you win. You want to, you know, reach goal after goal after goal. You don't want to reach all the goals at once. So the Kingdom of France is actually pushing so hard into the Commune of France that I like, we can see light at the end of the tunnel right now. Let's have a look at air superiority. Still garbage. I'm gonna stop with this stuff because it's honestly not even effective anymore over here. And I think we should probably send them home, and we'll figure that out, that stuff out later. Send these guys home as well. God fucking damn it, dude. 90,000 manpower in the People's Republic of China. Let's take this first. And afterwards we can possibly take this as well, because we have a lot of people from different angles. This is a bit too heavy for us, I think. This one we can't attack from multiple directions until we take multiple tiles around it. This one we can attack Burgos. Only from two directions though, so I don't want to do that one yet. Actually no, I think I do. We'll have to delete the front line. I'll do this. We'll attack from two different directions. And we've got morning mood. I'm honestly surprised that we aren't getting we have a lot of troops here. I was about to say we aren't getting any resistance to occupation, but we have troops in pretty much every state that we hold over here. Oh, okay, the naval landing was a success, boys. I want to send troops over here to finish this encirclement. Just pushing from this tile into that would be enough. I'll probably send the tank as well as a couple of elite troops suited to that environment, possibly the mountain troops and a couple of infantry troops down there in a bit. That'll probably have to be next episode though, because we are over time. So, with the tides once again turning and us actually seeing victory in our grasp, at least a liberation of Europe, maybe by the end of the year, maybe by before the end of the next year, not this Christmas, maybe next Christmas or the one after that, but the liberation of Europe is now actually in view compared to what it was before. Thank you so much for watching. As always, you can find the social media bullshit in the description down below, as well as my Patreon link, where you can go to support me on Patreon through monthly pledges. It only charges you at the first of every month, and you can pay $1 and up, however much you want to do and or want to give, and it's all on the same tier. So everyone gets the same reward, or the same amount of money, or for whatever amount of money you pay. Anyways, that is about it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.